Well, we're doing finger painting with Oh-Lew-Chee. And what I'm going to do is I put my paper right here. I put this right here. So for my homemade easel, as you can see, I'm going to take this paper down so that it can stay on. What you need, you can make your own homemade easel. What you need to make your homemade easel is I have a box and I have another box in the back of it. You need your paper, any kind of paper that you want. I have this poster paper. It's the sign paper, see? This is how big it is. And I'm using different techniques. I'm going to use the chromatic paint. And I said, it's good that you could use your fingers. Use your fingers for dexterity. What I want you to do is tape it to the side. Tape it to the side. Now, what I've already done is that I use yellow. I use yellow and I use green. So right now I use the tip of my fingers. You can use your fingers to do this because it helps with the dexterity so that you can use. This is also good for people with MS, arthritis, and anyone that has problems with their fingers. If you can't hold a brush or in your hand to paint, use your fingers. Right now I'm using yellow and red, and I'm going to do different designs to see how it's going to come out. So you can also do this with me. Okay, I'm going to get my fingers back in the paint. As you can see, my fingers have it, and I'm just going to do whatever comes to mind. I'm gonna have some red. Do some more yellow. Looks like little grass. Like a yellow field.
Oh yeah. I got a pile of work, presentation tomorrow, daily workout, and lots of stuff. Make time every day for the work. It's the most mental chocolate.
Or to be fire. However you want it to be.
Is it charming?
It's too thick. And you can make it whatever you want it to be. It could be whatever. Whatever your mind takes you, it could be. field of whatever, whatever. Folks, whatever floats your boat, that's what I say. Let some yellow in there, mix it together. Now you have your field with your... Have it straight up. Mix it. Get into it. You never know. Somebody else might see one thing and you'll see something else. So just keep doing what you're doing. And painting is whatever you want it to be. Whatever you want this picture to be, it will be. Whatever you see in your mind, just let it out on paper. Play some nice soft music behind it. It's like, never know. Make sure you get all in the little nooks and crannies. Go ahead, do that. This is absolutely beautiful. I would have never thought of this. This is my first time doing this just out of nowhere. Looks like fire just coming out. Fire just. Spirit of a dragon. That's what it could be. Taking its own shape. Whatever it is. Just let it take a shape of itself. Whatever it's going to come out to be, it's going to be. Get some of this. See, whatever you do is going to come out. Whatever your mind telling you to draw, that's what you do. You draw. And this is my first time, like I said, I'm doing it. Squeeze as much as you can. Get that texture that you want. You stand back, look at what you've created. Something totally different. You would have never thought that you could do something like this. But we don't know it until we try. Hold on, please. Fill in. Oh, some more yellow. Red. Blue. Blue. Oh, white. Here we are. Just had to get some more paint here. I do have yellow. I want yellow to be the dominant color. That's right. The bright yellow. like mostly the red and the yellow. Mix it. You feel like orange. Okay. And you can also use, I'm going to use the end of my paintbrush, I'm going to use the end of this to add some of the to use yellow and blue mix green. So I'm going to mix some blue. I'm going to mix some of this blue here with the some blue, and I'm going to use some yellow, and I'm going to mix it. See, when you mix it, when you mix the colors, mix this color, comes out to green. So yellow and blue make green. I'm going to make some grass. And I have my green. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make some green pastures here. Matter of fact, I'm going to use this paintbrush right here. I'm just going to dab, dab, dab. I think I have one. Matter of fact, I'm not going to need to continue to use my fingers to make the grass. That's going to help Hi, Boo Boo. What you doing? You eat, Mama? You eat? You see me painting? Yeah. You see Mama painting? Don't touch that. Don't eat that. Doing my grass.
YouTubers.
And when I'm finished, you're gonna see the whole thing. Sometimes you want to make sure that your whole bottom piece, you know, then you can always go back. Using your fingers is great. Great idea. Don't let nobody tell you different. Use whatever techniques you have, whatever you have in your house, or whatever, however you want to paint your picture, you paint it. Because if you can't hold the paintbrush, this is the best way. This, mix it. If I get some white, have some white, I can put a little bit and make it a little lighter. Yellow. Make sure you put your tops back on your paintings, because you don't want them to come up looking, you don't want them to dry out. So always put your tops back on. And then you go back to mixing. Make that green that you want. Yellow and blue, see? I use some of this yellow so that I can add a little bit of yellow in there. Make a nice, pretty fall color. And look what you've made. You should be proud of yourself. I've never done this before. This is my first time ever. So now, I'm trying to think if I want to, I gotta do something in this area right here. You sometimes you can have negative space, but you wanna make sure that your painting or your drawing is balanced. So now it's a little, I have to fix this. Oh, I can put a little hole right there and get some rest. Get some black.
Get some black.
Just a tad. Just a tad.
You want to mix it with some of these other colors that you have in there.
You know, for the swirl, make that like a little entrance. Like a little button, too.
They kind of
next we have life, we're going to give it some life. Let's try a little bit of try some light in there. Give it a little shade.
Give it a little depth there, right?
Just a little bit, not a whole lot. I'm using a Q-tip.
Using a Q-tip, give it a little bit of
pizzazz here and there. You want to blend your colors along.
Come on up.
Like an old tree. Old tree.
Yes, I want you to continue. My tree, kind of, gotta get that. There you go. Let's get it all in. Give it some branches. I want to use this green. I'm going to use the green for using to make like little branches in there. Make keep the street kind of lit alive. Really happens just to be going everywhere. Colors will pop out with this blue.
Mama.
sprinkles, everyone. Was it on a bed? She wants to look out the window. As you can see, coming out, something totally different. You can always go back and paint. Put in what's been taken out, always. But like I said, sometimes it's best, I've always been told it's best to do the background first. But if you don't know how your painting is going to come out, then you start off with what you know best. So, right now, just painting in. First time I've ever done something like this, using my fingers and different colors and different, you know, techniques. This is great. I love it. I can actually paint all in here and watch what comes out. With your paintbrush, and just go to work. So you can always paint it back in. See what happened? You just cut it right out. And right over. And you will see what's going to happen next. Where did it go? What's going on over there? It's beautiful. Isn't that beautiful? And this, whatever you want it to be, it is whatever you want it to be. It could be a curvy person, a curvy, it could be, yes, curves. I'm going to outline it, I'm going to let it dry some. And it just, this, when you use this paint, it doesn't really take long to dry, but it's really good. And even though it's all over my hands, that's what artists do. We wipe it on our shirt. Whatever. And it came out to be a person. I really like it. I love it. I'm so proud of myself. Not to stand back. You always stand back, turn around, and you look at your work. If it's something that can capture the whole camera, you've done good. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to watch this. I want you to check this out. We can see. Coming out beautiful. Like an illusion of a head in the back. think, whatever you feel. As you can see, beautiful. You can see what is going on there. Beautiful. Yes. That is gorgeous. Ladies and gentlemen, a masterpiece. I call this holding up love. I'm gonna put my name on it. No name. Oh, never mind. I'm gonna put my name on it. Ladies and gentlemen, this can be whatever you want it to be. Put my name. Two. Put the year. And I'm putting in 2/15. This is when it was done. Put my last name. Well, I hope you enjoyed painting with the Oh-Lew-Chee. Me and my co-host, come Twinkle, come real quick, don't eat my hand. Me and my counterpartner want to thank you for joining us today. And we hope that you will continue to join with me every second Saturday of the month. We're going to do creativity with the Oh-Lew-Chee. However you feel, whatever you want to do is up to you. And if you hold on, I have another painting that I would like to show you. So, we've done two paintings today. And you can have your own art gallery in your house. This is done with different media. And you also see who's holding up the world. Holding up love. Love hold us up. That's what's called. Love hold us up. Like I said, I thank you for joining us, and I pray that this has been something that you will be interested in. Tune in again
I want you, if you like this, I want you to like this video, press like for this video so that we can continue to share our creativity. Once again, I am Oh-Lew-Chee, and you are doing creativity with Oh-Lew-Chee. Thank you.